Outbound Music, the web's number one source for new and independent music. Check out outboundmusic.com, your source for new music.
Fear. The mind is fear.
Hey everybody, this is your big daddy O, Gene Hoagland, the Atomic Clock himself, and you are listening to Tina on the Big Rock Show, and she's awesome and amazing, and you are awesome and amazing for listening. What do you say, kids? This is Bobby Blitz from Overkill coming at you on the Big Rock Show. If it's the Big Rock Show, this must be Tina. You're in the right place.
Hey, this is John from Echoson, and you're listening to Tina with the Big Rock Show.
Welcome to Season 6 of The Big Rock Show, with your host, Tina Peak.
Oh my god, yes!
New episodes, new music, and new interviews. For more information, check out thebigrockshow.net.
Hey folks, welcome to The Big Rock Show. Yes, I'm back. I had a great time in Cozumel, Mexico for a couple of weeks, but we all have to face reality eventually, even though I didn't want to. Okay, so March is going to kick ass. I've got some cool bands coming on the show this month, and we're starting off with Canadian metalers Titans Eve. They've just released their debut album, The Devine Equal, and founding member, lead vocalist, Brian Gamblin, will be joining me in just a few minutes for a chat. I'd like to play you a couple of songs off the new disc. The second one, called Tides of Doom, I'll play for you after the interview. So, welcome to the show, turn it up, sit back, and relax. Here's the first tune. It's called Becoming the Demon, and it's by Titans Eve.
RatPackRecords.com.
New bands for the next generation of hard rock fans.
You know their songs.
My.
Rat Pack Records.
RatPackRecords.com. Visit RatPackRecords.com.
New bands for the next generation of hard rock fans.
Welcome to the Big Rock Show. We're going to party our tits off today. I think you know that. I know that. The American people know that. It's going to be a great program. So just go ahead and squeeze your girth and sit back and listen.
Hello.
Hi, Brian. It's Tina from The Big Rock Show. How are you?
Good, Tina. How are you?
Not doing too bad. What's shaking? Are you out in Vancouver?
I am, actually. I'm just walking downtown here in busy old Vancouver.
Oh, are you? What's the weather like out there? Is it nice or cold or what?
Well, you know, it's kind of a mix. It's a bit cold. It's been a bit colder. We had snow here, and we haven't had snow for like a month, so we had snow here all last night and today a bit, too, so...
Yeah, Vancouver's been getting a lot more snow this year.
Vancouver's colder this year. I don't know what it is.
Yeah, well, you guys deserve that. You've been getting too much balmy weather, as far as I'm concerned.
Yeah, I know. It's one of those things, you know. I'm from Alberta, right? So it'd be like 40 below outside where I'm from in Rocky Mountain House, and I'd get up and see the weather report, and it'd be +2, +5 in Vancouver, and I'd hate everyone there.
I'm in Ontario, so we hear all about this balmy summer-like weather Vancouver gets. We get kind of jealous out here.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I can understand that.
All right, well now, Brian, Titans Eve have already been super busy this year, so I thought, you know, we could talk about some of the stuff that's been going on with you guys.
Absolutely, it sounds good, Tina.
All right. Well, the band's debut album was just released on February 1st called The Devine Equal, and it features 11 epic metal tunes influenced from the famous 17th century poem Paradise Lost by poet John Milton and the Book of Genesis. It's a great metal disc. I've been listening to it all week, and I'm really digging it. Tell us about those influences from the first book of the Hebrew Bible and the Christian Old Testament, and the reason for using that theme on your debut disc.
First of all, thank you very much. Glad that you're liking the album. When I was in college, taking guitar theory and that kind of thing, and brushing up on that sort of thing, I was really into John Milton's Paradise Lost and Genesis, and kind of like the overall theme. What I wanted to do was take those things. It's such a great story. You know, the Book of Genesis, the metaphor of the Garden of Eden and the forbidden fruit and being influenced by the serpent, and kind of take it with John Milton did with Paradise Lost, with the rebellion in heaven with Lucifer and all that, and kind of relate it all through a story from track one, Morning Star, which is another name for Satan. When he came out of heaven, he fell from heaven, people said he would look like a star coming down. But what I want to do is I want to take that story. We're not satanic at all. That's one thing I would clear up with people. I just want to take that story of the first rebel, the rebellion, and just kind of relate it to people's lives, because everyone falls and everyone rises. You know, it's just empowering.
Right. No, I get that. So how did you figure that this would fall into a metal thrash genre? Because it's quite interesting that you were able to do that.
The story?
Yeah.
Well, you know, I hear a lot of these, there's a lot of new bands or, you know, out there that are kind of emo based or, and, you know, it's kind of like metal, but it isn't, you know, they're singing about, either relationships and all that stuff. And I just didn't want to be one of those bands that would, you know, sing about all these small problems. I wanted to write about something with substance, a story as old, you know, as the Book of Genesis. I wanted to relate that with people and kind of empower them with that. And choosing metal as a genre, you know, that's what I've always loved to play, is metal. I like the technicality behind it, from classical infused, you know, even jazz, all that stuff. And that's why it worked really well, is because it's a powerful subject for a very powerful genre of music.
Yeah, it is. I totally agree with that. Now, your brother Kyle is in the band as well. Did the two of you start Titans Eve?
That's right, yes. Well, what happened was I've always played music, and I got Kyle into guitar. I wanted to train him up because I was sick of guitarists flaking out and lead singers and all that flaking out. So I trained Kyle up, and then once that was done, I had my right-hand man. What we did is we came to Vancouver. We saved up a bunch of money, sold a trailer so we could invest in this band, moved to Vancouver, which is the closest musical area at the time where we could do a lot of gigging and that kind of thing. And that's what we did. And we formed Titans Eve.
Now, where does the name Titans Eve derive from? Where did you guys come up with that?
Well, I wanted something that sounded powerful, and it was as simple as this. I wanted something that sounded powerful, and my brother wanted something that kind of meant the beginning of something. So we were sitting over some drinks, and I pretty much said, "What about Titans?" And my brother said, "Oh, okay, that's all right." And he said, "Eve." I said, "Well, what about Titans Eve?" It was like Titans Eve, that was it.
Wow. What's it like having a sibling in the band? Does it make life easier? Does it make it more difficult?
I think it makes life easier because Kyle and I, we've been our entire lives together, so we pretty much said and did everything mean possible to one another. It's kind of like if a fight happens, we know it's going to be okay in 10 minutes.
Yeah.
I think it's better.
Yeah, cool. Now, did the two of you do most of the lyrical writing in the band?
Yeah, him and I do all the writing.
You do all the writing. And who are the other members in the band, Brian?
We got Casey Ory, an awesome drummer. We recruited him when we got down here. He had been in past musical projects here, and we got him to do the drumming for us, and just spectacular, brings a new power to the songs. Then our bass player actually recruited him from our hometown. We had about five other bass players before him. I finally wanted someone I could rely on and know that they'd stick by my side. So he moved and gave up everything in Alberta that he had going to come join us, Jesse Horde.
Awesome. Now, is it true that Titans Eve are already working on their next album?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We're very busy getting that stuff together right now because we want to, we're touring on the Devine Equal album, and at the same time we're writing the next album. We kind of want it, as soon as we're done touring, to have the next album out, promo that, get people, you know, listening and liking the new songs, hopefully, and then tour on that and just keep the machine going, because that's what we love to do. We love writing powerful metal, and we love gigging.
Is it true that this next album is a concept album and it's titled Life Apocalypse?
It's another concept album, Life Apocalypse, and I got a character that I'm working with right now for the basis of the whole thing, for like a storyline, and I'm going to release that information as we get closer to the end of the album writing.
And when do you guys go in to start tracking for the next new disc?
We are starting in April.
Oh, are you? So all have all the songs been written already?
We got a majority of them.
Really? That's awesome, Brian.
Yeah, we